of Ben's custom-made kebaya. It's absolutely gorgeous.
They're pretty, yeah. And every piece is a piece of art, because the colors that you use, you cannot follow them back again, even though you try to trace the colors back, it's really hard. Because yeah. Everyone shows different ways, so it's not like coloring how
it's
you do the
painting.
Show. It's a painting.
Yeah,
yeah.
Right.
So the beautiful part of our kebaya is we use top quality DNC thread.
Mm-hmm.
So after when you do the embroidery, you can see a little shine, not very shiny, but a little shine.
Mm.
Okay, and also very, very smooth. And it lasts for ages.
No, it feels really firm.
Right.
And I haven't seen a black kebaya very often.
Yeah, in the good old days, black is only used for morning. But today, because of modern, that people like for evening, looks slim and elegant,
yeah.
Right? So we use black, but we try to play lots of colors. Like, see, like this, we play a very strong orange and red to give note the prosperity color.
Right, and what is this? Is this a particular motif or flower?
Yeah, this is a type of orchid. It represents Singapore. Of course, Singapore is very famous for the flowers, orchids. We export our orchids all around the world. So in any country you see orchids, you will say, oh, this is from Singapore. So we design pieces like that for influence wears, for corporates that comes in to Singapore to visit. It's a very official influence wear.
Mm. So yeah. In getting you to make a kebaya like this for me, it would be perfectly tailored to my...
Yes. So there's few steps of doing the kebaya. So you come to me, first we need to take the measurement of your body.
Mm-hmm.
You will use the kebaya to take the measurement. In the good old days kebaya to today, for my style of kebaya, you don't use measurement tape to take the size.
Okay.
You have to wear a kebaya, from there you gauge. Then you will use that to trace to the paper and cut into the fabric.
Well, that's interesting.
Yeah. So after cutting the fabric, then you will stitch up, then you will try again. Once it fits well, then you will choose the flower.
Right.
Then what flower you like, then after you imprint the flowers on the fabric, and then you will start to do the embroidery.
How about Australian flowers?
It's all flowers that are very nice.
That would be fun. And what sarong would you match with this kind of
After the pieces is completed, then you will kind of find the sarong. Sarong normally you try to match it like not really similar color. You clash it a bit, so you can see two stars,
okay.
One on top and one bottom.
Okay.
You don't exactly wear the whole thing the same color.
Oh, interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I've often thought that there is some similarity between sarong kebaya and the Japanese kimono.
Mm.
And
to wear a kebaya is something like wearing a traditional kimono, because you need to know how to tie the sarong.
Mm.
It's not a skirt, it's a piece of cloth of fabric, so you need to know how to roll them, to wrap them well, to make it look clean and elegant to wear.
And make sure the design's not upside down.
Yeah,
white
and
the
flower,
white flowers upside
down. Upside down, everything that you wear there. And also to wear a kebaya, I don't modify the kebaya into a skirt or this, because when I design a kebaya, I want my guests to wear them traditional way.
I see.
Like all the way back to ancient times.
Okay, so you would, but this is kind of modern in some ways.
Modern in color,
mm.
Only the color, but everything's still traditional.
Okay, very interesting.
Mm.
Thank you.
Yes.